Hello everyone, so today we'll discuss about the Hibernate JPA one to many relationship. So here we have two entities as an example. So one is the author and second is the book, and one author is associated with the multiple book. That means we have one to many relationship here. So in terms of a relationship graph, we have author as one of the table and book is the second table. So in author table we have ID and a name, two different columns, and in the book we have ID, name and the foreign key as the third column, which is the primary key of the author table. So here in this example, we have one author is associated to the three different books as a foreign key in the book table. So that means this author has written three books. So that means one author is associated to the multiple books, which is like one to many relationship. Yeah, so I'll take you to the code now. So in the code, I have a Spring Boot application. So the properties of this application file is that I'm connecting to my local database. The database name is one to many using my local username and password, and the driver class I'm using is the JDBC, and the application is running on the port number 7770. So I'll run the application. So yeah, once the application will be running, we'll be using Postman to see what are the different APIs we can hit and how the data is flowing from the author and the book table. So meanwhile, I'll go and explain the entity tables here. So we have a class called author, which is an entity type. And here we have the ID and a name property, and the third is a book. So this author is associated to multiple books like this. There is a relationship one to many. That means one author is associated to multiple books. And in other ways, you can see many books are associated with the one author. So, and the join column here is the author foreign key, which is reference to ID of the author table. Yeah, so in the book entity, we have the ID and the title, two properties here. And yeah, so this is the model package, and we have for request, we have the DTO package here. So in the DTO, we have an author as one of the request, and in the controller, the author controller, I'm having the some of the APIs like add the author, then I have an update the author, then find all the authors, then get the author by ID and delete a given author by using the ID. So these are some of the APIs. So I'll be going to run this application. Means application is already running. So before that, I'll just show the ER diagram. ER diagram, as we have already mentioned, like it is having the author is ID and the name, and the book is the ID, title, and author foreign key. Yeah. So if I just run this two queries. Second, let me run. So here we don't have any entries as of now in the tables. So I'll go and use the Postman, and I'll be using the post API here to save the data. So once I do the send, yeah, so to as you can see the response we are having, we get the IDs here, like the one of the author is created with ID 1, and the two books associated with this author are created with ID 1 and 2. So if I go and look at the tables, so my author table will be having one entry, and in book table there will be two entries here associated with the same foreign key as the author. So I'll be having other methods here as well, like add author. I can also go and find all the authors. So as of now we have only one author. So even though we can use it and get all the authors, so it will give us a response as like, oh, there is only one author. So it will return only one author. And yeah, we have also we can also get the author using ID. So if we pass the ID as a one, we will get the author as well. And we can also go and delete the author. So if I use the delete API and send the request, we'll see the status goes to 200, means the author is deleted. If I try to get the author, so it says like the author with ID 1 is not found, means the author is already deleted. If I go and look at my database and see, refresh, the author is deleted. And if the author is deleted, the book will be also deleted, because we have a cascade all misplaced in the during the relationship. Yeah, so that is pretty much about like one to many relationship, how we can achieve using a Spring Boot. Yeah, so थैंक यू।